We want to demonstrate practically the way it should be done.
Part 7, circular motion. An object moving with a constant speed along a circular path is said to have a uniform circular motion. Examples of circular motion are a stone tied to a string, which is moved in horizontal or vertical circle. Number 2, a satellite circling around the Earth, a moon circling the Earth, and the Earth moving around the Sun. 5, the planet moving around the Sun. Now, this is the picture of a circle. When you look at this circle, you see that object P is moving from A and up to this point. It's moving anti-clockwise. The distance along the circle is S, while the velocity or speed along the circle is omega. We are going to start from known to unknown. In the last 10 set of video, we discussed our distance, velocity, speed, acceleration, and the rest of them. So we are going to start with linear distance, which you are familiar with. Then we move to angular distance. Now, distance is uniform velocity times time. The symbol of distance is this, S. The symbol of velocity is this. And the symbol of time is T. That is linear distance for motion in a straight line. In the case of angular distance, S is equal to R theta. In mathematics, this is an arc. An arc is part of a circle. This is an arc. And when you want to find the length of an arc, in mathematics, the length of an arc is equal to theta over 360 times 2 pi r. So from this formula, we derive the length of this arc AP, which is equal to x, that is distance along the arc. We use theta times r. We remove 2 pi, because they use 2 pi here in mathematics when they want to compensate for the reduction in the diameter as you move towards the pole, Arctic and Antarctic circle. When an object is moving toward the Arctic and Antarctic circle and you are calculating the distance along the equator, the diameter on horizontal and vertical lines of longitude and latitude, we make use of these. But in physics, our S is equal to R theta. We don't have anything to do with 2 pi. Now, this 360, later I will explain it. That is for motion in a circle. Now, circular distance in food. As the angle or theta in the circular figure above change with time, when you are moving anti-clockwise, this arc will also change. So if you use S to represent the distance along the arc, S is equal to AP. As this length is changing with time, angular distance is given by
at length as divided by the time taken, which is theta, theta is equal to s of r, and s is equal to r theta, which we got here before. Now, that is that. We note from the diagram above that the particle P, this is particle P, move from A up to that point, run the circle once. It will travel through an angle theta is equal to 360. The maximum angle in the circle is 360 degrees. And this is also equal to 2 pi radian in trigonometry and further mathematics. In time t, the period of oscillatory motion is given by t. The rate of change of the angle theta with time t is known as the angular speed. This is the angular speed. And this one is angle turn through the body all over time taken. The symbol of angular speed is omega. The symbol of angle turn through the body is theta. And the symbol of time taken is t. The angle is measured in radians, and since 2 pi radian is equal to 360, we have from angle, omega is equal to theta over t that the angular speed is measured in radian per second. Now, let us examine the relationship between linear and angular speed. Now, V is equal to S alpha T from linear distance. Linear distance. And we also know that S is equal to R theta from angular distance. From angular distance, when we substitute s equal to r theta in equation 2, in this equation 1, substitute s is equal to r theta in equation 1, phi is equal to S over T become R theta over T. And this one will give us R multiplied by theta over T. And omega is equal to theta over T. From the angular speed, we are able to find here. So, from angular speed, therefore, V is equal to R omega. V is equal to R omega, or V is equal to omega r. Therefore, linear speed is equal to the product of angular speed and the radius of amplitude.